In the previous video, we solved the system using the Gauss-Jordan elimination. This video, we're going to use Gauss-Jordan elimination method. Okay, so you start the same. Okay, you make a matrix, then you write coefficients for each row, for each variable: 1, 2, negative 3, and this is going to be augmented matrix because there's an equal sign. So you're gonna make a dotted line where the equal sign is, and then there's a 6. The second row, 2 coefficient, negative 1, 4, 1. 1, the last row, negative 1, 1, 3. Okay, so you have to have leading ones, just like in the Gaussian elimination, right? There's a certain number of steps that is exactly the same as in the Gaussian elimination, right? So so first, you will make this leading one. So this column should start from 1, and everything else should be 0. Right? So we need to transform the second row and third row so that instead of 2 there's a 0, instead of 1 there's a 0. So we're gonna say that row 2 minus 2 times row 1, and then row 3 minus row 1. Okay, so this is an operation. So that's gonna give us, copying the first row is the same as it was because we didn't do anything to it. So we will have 0 and 0, right? Because 2 minus 2 times 1 is 0. Negative 1 minus twice 2 is negative 1 minus 4, negative 5. 4 minus negative 6, twice, right? Minus negative 6 is plus, so that's 10. 1 minus 12, right? 1 minus 12 is negative 11. Then 1 minus 1, 0, negative 1 minus 2, negative 3. 1 minus negative 3 is 1 plus 3, that's 4. And then 3 minus 6 is negative 3. So now we have to make sure that the next leading one will be in the second row instead of negative 5. So we need to multiply the second row by negative 1 over 5. Negative 1 over 5 times row 2. So that's going to be... So first and last rows are the same, they don't change. Okay, so 0, 1, right, because 0 times non-zero is still 0. This is negative 5 times negative 1 over 5, which is exactly 1 as we wanted. 10 times negative 1 over 5 is negative 2. Negative 11, 2 negatives, positive, so 11 over 5. Now if we copy this down, 0, negative 3, 4, negative 3. Okay, so now this is where the Gauss-Jordan part comes in, right? In the Gaussian elimination, we would make sure that below this one, the leading one, this negative 3 would turn into a 0. But in the Gauss-Jordan elimination, we got to make sure that not only this negative 3 is a 0 below the 1, but also above the leading 1, this number 2 is also a 0. Right, so we have to have two operations. So I'm going to write one operation on top and one operation below the arrow. So the first one will be row 1. So row 1 minus 2 times row 2. That will make sure that 2 minus 2 times 1, that's going to be 2 minus 2 is 0, right? That will make sure that this 2 will turn to 0. Row 3 plus 3 times row 2, right? Because there's a negative 3, so negative 3 plus 3 will give you 0, all right? So let's see. So the first row, so row 1 minus 2 times row 2, keep in mind that the 1 will still be there, that's the beauty of it, because the 0, no matter what the non-zero is going to be, and even if it were 0, it will still be 0, right? So this 1 will not change as a result, right? Then 2 minus 2 row 1, 0. That's what we wanted. Negative 3 minus negative minus 2 times negative 2, so that's plus 4. Negative 3 plus 4 is 1. 6 minus 22 over 5, right? 6 minus 22 over 5, so that's 30 over 5 minus 22, so that's 8 over 5. I'm just doing this in my head, this math, right? 6 minus 11 over 5 is 8 over 5. The second row is copied over because we didn't do anything to it. We use it for other rows, right? But we didn't change the row itself. Now the third row. And again, row 3 plus 3 times row 2, 0 plus 3 times 0 is still 0. That's the beauty of it. You're not changing, you're not violating the Gauss that you've done for the first column. You see, it remains intact. That's the beauty of the Jordan elimination that we had. Negative 3 plus 3 times 1, 0. Bingo. See? 4 plus 3 times negative 2. So 4 minus 6, negative 2. Negative 3 plus 33 over 5. So negative 15 plus 33 over 5. So that's going to be 33 minus 15. The numerator, 33 minus 15 is 18. Right, so that should be positive, right? So that should be 18 over 5. I just did this in my head, 18 over 5. Okay, so now one more thing. We need to transform this negative 2 into positive 1, and then accordingly after that we will have to make sure that the negative 2 and 1 are both 0 in the third column. And that will complete the Gauss-Jordan elimination. And then I'm going to explain to you why the Gauss-Jordan elimination is actually useful. All right? So we need to have one operation for the last row. Negative 1 half times row 3. That will make sure this will turn into a 1. All right? So then we will have... So the first two rows are copied over. 0, 1, negative 2, 11 over 5, and then so negative 1 half, and again the zeros will not change because Nadan 0 times 0 is still 0. 0, 0, and then this turns into a 1, right? Because this times that is 1. And then 18 over 5 times negative 1 half, that's negative 9 over 5. Negative 9 over 5. Let me write that 5. Like that. So negative 9 over 5. So, as I said, one more thing. Making sure that these guys are 0. So, I'm just going to write arrow there. So, row 1 minus row 3. Right? 1 minus 1 will make sure that the row 1 will have a 0 in there. Row 2 plus 2 times row 3, right? Plus 2 times row 3. That will make sure that negative 2 plus 2 times 1, that will give you 0 for this negative 2, right? So we're transforming row 1 and row 2 using row 3, right? So row 1 minus row 3, 1 minus 0, still intact, 1. And that's exactly what we want. 0 minus 0, still 0. 1 minus 1, 0, and that's what we wanted, right? That's 0 instead of 1. 8, 5 minus negative 9 over 5, so 8 plus 9, right? 17 over 5. Perfect. Row 2 is intact. No. Row 2 will be changing, right? Row 3 is copied, right? So let's copy row 3 as it was. Negative 9 over 5, like that. Maybe I should use colors so that you can distinguish the line here, so that you're not confusing it with the numbers using black, like that. Okay, so that's better. Okay, so row 2 plus 2 times row 3, 0 plus twice 0, still 0, and that's what we want. 1 plus 2 times 0, still 1, right? And that's what we want. We don't want to touch the leading ones. And the Jordan elimination does not change the Gaussian elimination procedures that we have used. Excellent. Negative 2 plus 2 times 1, 0. And that's what we wanted, right? Because the leading one in the third column is going to be the third row number, which is this one. Now, finally, some algebra. 11 over 5 plus twice negative 9 over 5. So 11/5 minus 18 over 5. So that's going to be negative 7 over 5, I believe, right? So negative 7 over 5. So now you might ask me, why is Jordan elimination so useful? Well, check this out. This serves as the new coefficients, right? You see that the only coefficients that are non-zero are the leading ones. And these coefficients, each of them belong to a separate variable. This first variable is x to the 1. So I'm going to write result. The result is x to the 1, the first variable, coefficient 1, means 1 times x to the 1, right? So x to the 1 is what? X to the 1 plus 0 times x to the 2, right? The coefficient for the second variable, plus 0 times x to the 3 is equal to 17 over 5. So what does that mean? It means that x, the first variable, is equal to 17 over 5. So I'm not going to write this whole thing now for the second variable, but you can see the logic. The second variable, x to the 2, has a coefficient 1, so we can just write x to the 2. X subscript 2 is going to be simply negative 7 over 5, right? It's like a shortcut to solving for each variable already when you've completed your Jordan elimination part of the Gaussian elimination. And then x to the 3, x subscript 3, the last variable, is simply negative 9 over 5. Right? Because this dotted line is the equal sign substitution, right? So basically x to the 3rd, 1 times x subscript 3 is x subscript 3 itself, right? Equals negative 9 over 5. So look what happened, guys. You actually came to the solution without using back substitution. As you've seen in the previous video, when I've used Gaussian elimination, we used back substitution after we first found the third variable, x subscript 3. We used that variable to find x subscript 2, and then we used these both variables to find x subscript 1, because these numbers were not zero in the first row when we've used Gaussian elimination, when we've completed all the steps. They were non-zero. So we had to actually depend on x subscript 2 and x subscript 3 to find x subscript 1. But since now the coefficients of the x subscript 2 and x subscript 3 are zero, we can disregard them and we can basically solve directly for the first variable x subscript 1, which is equal to 17 over 5. So that's what Gauss-Jordan elimination does. It provides a shortcut. I mean, there's more work, because obviously I'll tell you where we stop in the Gaussian elimination. In the Gaussian elimination, you would stop here. This would be your Gaussian elimination, because you would say that x subscript 3 is negative 9 over 5. As you can see, it would not change. Then you would use that to find x subscript 2, because the x subscript 3 coefficient was negative 2, not 1, in the second row, right? So you had to be dependent on the third variable to solve for the second variable. And in the first variable, you had to be dependent on, well, actually, no, that's not Gaussian elimination. I'll show you where the Gaussian elimination is. The Gaussian elimination would involve you to basically to make sure that you would have 0 instead of negative 3, and then you would have to have 1 instead of negative 2, right? I mean, this is not completely Gaussian elimination. I mean, there are still some shortcuts available, as you can see, because there's a 0 in there. But in the Gaussian elimination, look at my previous video, you'll see that all of these three numbers would be non-zero, right? So the second one would still be not zero in the Gaussian elimination. But the Gauss-Jordan one makes sure that we only have leading ones as coefficients, so they provide a shortcut to direct arrival at these solutions. So hope this was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.